Welcome back. So far, what we have observed that for a given dynamical system or a given control system, one of the most important question people are asking that particular system is stable or not. Because what we have seen in the previous class that in a stable system or unstable system is potentially dangerous for the application. And due to that reason, stability is the one of the most important requirement. In the previous two classes, I have talked about the input-output stability, and what we have observed that if initial condition equal to zero and for the linear system, and if I apply bounded input, and suppose if I get bounded output, then we are defining that system as a stable system. So somehow that class of stability is called bounded input, bounded output stability. In today's lecture, I am going to talk about some different notion of stability, and in today's lecture I am going to assume that suppose my system has no external input. So it means that my system is fully governed by the initial condition, and if I have non-autonomous system, then that is governed by initial condition as well as explicit time variable. So we will see both kind of notion, and I have already told you that we have two different class of stability in case of linear system. One is called internal stability, another is called external stability. So internal stability means what is influence of the internal variable on the system performance we are going to look into. So basically, in today's lecture, I am going to talk about the internal stability in the sense of Lyapunov, because the internal stability theory that is developed for the nonlinear system, and whenever some result is developed for the nonlinear system, I have told you that that is equally applicable for linear system also. So first try to understand for the nonlinear system, and after that in next class I will take the particular portion of this and I will discuss for the linear system also. So I am going to start with the intuitive idea of the concept of internal stability or concept of stability in the sense of Lyapunov. So what Lyapunov has suggested that nonlinear system is very very complicated. So I have to select some kind of reference point, and we have to talk the behavior about that reference point. And you all are aware that I have always one important reference point inside the any dynamical system. It might possible I have more than one also, and that is nothing but equilibrium point. And what is beauty of equilibrium point? If system trajectory will start from that point, we are going to stay there forever if no external perturbation or force is going to act on that. So due to that reason, he has selected reference point as a equilibrium point. And after that, he is talking behavior about the equilibrium point, because if you start from the equilibrium point, you are going to stay there. But if you start in the vicinity of equilibrium point, obviously you have motion. So meaning of stability here, that if you start in the neighborhood of the equilibrium point, and if you are not going to diverge, or in another way, you are going to remain in the neighborhood of equilibrium point or reference point, then system is said to be stable. Otherwise, we are telling that that is unstable in sense of Lyapunov. So let us try to see this kind of things by very, very simple example. And here I have already told you that in this particular type of stability, we are talking about the stability of somehow autonomous system, because I am assuming that forcing function is not available. So suppose you have to talk about internal stability, and if forcing function is available, first you can design feedback in terms of the state variable, and after that you can talk about this stability. So most of time, whenever we are talking about autonomous system or some kind of autonomous robotics, some kind of satellite, after launching the satellite, that is governed by their own dynamics, and after that some inherent control system we are actually given to them. So that class of system, actually this kind of stability is very, very important. So here you can see that I have started with first order system x dot equal to u, and I am assuming that this is first order system. Due to that reason, I have written x belongs to R, and I have selected u equal to kx. So after that, this is my closed loop system. So now you can see that x dot equal to kx in this system, and suppose I have certain kind of initial condition. So I am going to define initial condition xt0 equal to x0. So I have started my system at xt equal to 0. You can equally assume I have started my system at 0. So now what is our situation? I have this kind of autonomous system. I have applied some kind of initial condition x0 to the system, and after that, whatever solution of this, that is xt. And inside this system, I have x dot equal to k into x. So now, choosing x0, that is on the neighborhood of the equilibrium point, I am going to see the behavior. So first, I have to calculate the equilibrium point of this autonomous system, and you already know that how to do that. Just you can put rate of change equal to 0. So x equal to 0 is the equilibrium point. So this is my equilibrium point. And after that, what I am telling now, suppose this x0 in the vicinity. So I have selected some vicinity. Suppose I have selected this vicinity. And now I am going to select some point. Suppose x0 is greater than 0 and k is positive. Then what happens? That k into x0, that is positive, so I will diverge. So my direction is not towards the equilibrium point, in this direction, because x0 is greater than 0 and x dot is also greater than 0 if k greater than 0. So I am assuming k less than 0, and this class of feedback is called negative feedback. So because k is negative here, I am assuming. After that, if k is negative, then now you can see that what happens, x greater than 0, k is negative, and x is positive, say, then x dot is negative. So it means that if I start inside this ball, so right hand side, what we have observed, if k is negative, then I always remains inside this particular region. Similarly, if you start in this negative side, then your x is less than 0, and x is less than 0, so k into x is now greater than 0. So this quantity is now greater than 0, and due to that reason, now x less than 0 and x dot greater than 0, so you are going to converge towards this direction. It means that if you start in this region, and in mathematics that is called ball. So here, shape of ball, you can see that just a line. So in mathematics, people are very, very flexible. So how basically define ball? So they are telling that okay, if you have some kind of vector quantity x and vector quantity x1, x2 up to xn, now you can take any norm. So in previous class, I have already talked about the norm of some vector. So suppose if I will take the p norm of this. So after taking the p norm, and suppose if this p norm, because this is a scalar quantity, if this is equal to a, then whatever region that is covered by this, that is called ball. And we are very lucky here that I have just first order system. So this particular norm is now nothing but absolute value. So, and people are also telling why ball. If you put here two norm, you can see that. And if you have second order system, then what happens? You have this kind of relation, x1 square plus x2 square or something like a square. And if you see this region, then this region is somehow ball in two dimensional plane. If you are in three dimensional plane, again, you have some kind of a sphere. And similarly in fourth dimension on fifth dimension. So due to that region, mathematician has defined some notion, generalized notion that is called ball. Now, let us try to see that what we have observed, that if my initial condition is in vicinity of this equilibrium point, then my future trajectory xt, that is going to remain in the vicinity of this equilibrium point. And this is the notion of stability. But if k greater than 0, we will actually diverge. Then system is unstable. So somehow, whenever we are talking about the stability, we are talking about the well-behavedness of the solution about some particular point. So this is a story about the equilibrium point. Later, it is possible to show that this concept can be generalized about the operating point. So in this particular figure, I have shown that what is meaning of unstability, that if you start in the vicinity of this particular equilibrium point, then you are going to diverge. One more important point, here my system is linear. Due to that region, I have some beautiful property that you can start anywhere. And after that, what happens? You have always converging behavior. So this kind of stability is called global stability. Or somehow, we are not only telling equilibrium point is stable, we are telling system is stable, because for any initial condition you can select, I have similar kind of behavior. But obviously for nonlinear system, I cannot talk like this. I will give you very, very simple example after some time. And here are similar kind of things. This system, if k is greater than 0, then all trajectory, even if you select in the very, very small vicinity of this equilibrium point, that will diverge. And due to that region, equilibrium point become unstable. And since this is linear system, so same kind of behavior, due to that region, we are telling system is unstable. But particularly for nonlinear system, we are telling that equilibrium point is stable or not stable. We are not talking about the whole system. But if we are talking about the input-output stability, we are talking about the stability of system. So that is some difference. So you have to see the difference very much carefully. Now let us try to come to the another problem, because most of time, whenever we are developing some class of system, then I have to maintain our system or our trajectory to some kind of operating point. So now equilibrium point is not only x equal to 0. I have to shift my equilibrium point somewhere. So suppose again, for simplicity, I have taken first order system, and suppose I want to maintain my equilibrium point x equal to 18 degree. So what I am telling, that I have some kind of temperature control system, and you can take the example of air conditioner, where role of air conditioner is to control the temperature of your room. And I am assuming that simplest dynamics, using that air conditioner is going to control the temperature, that is first order dynamics. So rate of change of temperature, and that is some control variable u. And after that, I am telling that I want to maintain this x variable is temperature, that equal to minus 18 degree. So if you are talking about the maintenance of something about the operating point, and after that, obvious requirement is that if some temperature fluctuation reflected in the outside of the environment, still my temperature remains the x equal to 18. It means that suppose in geometrical way or some kind of qualitative way, what we are telling that okay, this point is now not zero, this is something like 18 degree. Now if some fluctuation occur, then again, is it possible to maintain in the neighborhood of 18 or not? That is the meaning of stability. So whenever you are talking stability about some kind of operating point, then you have to shift your equilibrium point. And how to do that? You can define the error variable x minus 18, and after that you can see the rate of change of error variable, because x is coming from the system, so x is changing, due to that reason error is changing. And e dot equal to x dot equal to u, and after that now you have to define control system in terms of the error, not in the terms of the state. In previous example you have seen that I have defined kx, but here I'm going to define in k into e. And you can see that if k is less than 0, then again I have similar kind of behavior, means I can, if I will start nearby of 18 degree, then due to this dynamics, e dot equal to k into e, and here e less than 0. So due to some fluctuation in the temperature, this value x is now not 18 degree, something like 19 degree, then again some finite error comes into picture, and finally what happens? We will converge towards to the equilibrium point. So this is not e, this is basically k, k. So, or you can write e less than 0, then e dot greater than 0, because I have k less than 0. So like that also, that is okay. So let us now come to the some kind of nonlinear system, because what we have observed, that I have mentioned that whenever we are talking about stability, we are talking stability about the equilibrium point, internal stability particularly, where control is not involved. And if control is involved, then we are substituting control by some kind of, in terms of some state variable. And finally, my system is autonomous. Now, in the previous some lecture, I have already talked about the pendulum system. So try to see the pendulum system. And what we have observed in the case of pendulum system, that I have infinite many equilibrium point, and another beauty is that equilibrium point is also isolated, not connected equilibrium point. Obviously at one point I have infinite many point, that doesn't matter. So I have, this is equilibrium point, this is another first equilibrium point, and another equilibrium point of same pendulum is on the top. So try to see the behavior of these two equilibrium point. So by intuition, it is possible to show that if you give a small force to this, or a small, if here theta equal to 0, if you make theta equal to some finite value, then behavior is that this pendulum again come back to this position. Similar kind of things that is going to occur here. And due to that reason, what happens that if you give a small perturbation, initially suppose my pendulum is on the first equilibrium point, and if I apply a small perturbation, then you can see that I have some kind of converging behavior, in particularly in some particular region, and due to that region, this equilibrium point is called stable. Now let us try to see the behavior of this particular equilibrium point. So initially this is on equilibrium point, so this is on a state of rest, because I am not going to apply any force. But if you apply a small force, then you can see that is not going to maintain their equilibrium point. They will diverge, surely that they will diverge, either force will act in this direction or this direction, and due to that reason this is called unstable equilibrium point. So this is not stable, this is unstable equilibrium. So here you can see that I cannot talk about stability or instability of pendulum system, because about one equilibrium point that is showing the converging behavior or well behavedness, other and about another equilibrium point that is not showing the well behavedness. And due to that reason, we are talking about stability about the equilibrium point, not the stability of whole system. And obviously, this is very, very simple nonlinear system, pendulum system. And due to that reason, most of time, if you turn on any book, then they are taking example of this particular pendulum system. In some class, I have also taught about some kind of the geostationary satellite. So I have, this is our Earth, and after that I have to maintain some satellite here. So now I have to maintain this circular path or some kind of elliptical path, you can tell, about the center of Earth, such that this will rotate, and Earth will also rotate with some particular speed, such that these two remain stationary. So due to some forcing function, unwanted forcing function, if this satellite will leave this position, or attitude of satellite is not remains fixed, then what is our requirement? We want that after some time, again it back to the same orbit. And when this is possible, if system is stable. So, or at least in worst case, what we are assuming that attitude of this will not change much. So if some perturbation will act, then this will maintain in this particular region. So at least after any perturbation, this satellite will maintain this particular region. So this is the meaning of stability. If this will leave this region, then whatever satellite we have launched, that is not useful for us. And due to that reason, stability about some kind of operating point is also very, very important. So using these two examples, you are able to feel the meaning of stability. Both are nonlinear system. And obviously, we have seen that if you linearize about this particular orbit, then this is nothing but some kind of time-varying linear system. So LTV system, linear time varying system. So now let us come to the formal definition. So in today's class, I am just going to give you the formal means discussion. And actually, in order to understand definition, you have to understand the concept of epsilon and delta. So I hope that some of you are aware, some of you might not be aware. So please do not worry. In next class, when I will solve some problem related to stability, at that time first I will teach you how to calculate epsilon and delta ball, and based on that first I will teach you that what is meaning of limit, and after that I will tell you that how to talk about the stability. So for today's lecture, just try to understand the intuition. So for simplest case, I am going to start my lecture with autonomous nonlinear dynamical system, because I have told you that if this result is true for autonomous nonlinear system, then equally that is true for linear system. So I have taken this system x dot equal to fxt, and this is my initial condition. And after that, what I am going to assume, that this nonlinear system, mathematical model of this nonlinear system, is only valid in some particular region, and that particular region is D. So I am assuming that whatever state that belongs to D, and D is the proper subset of Rn. It means that whatever mathematical model I have considered, that is not valid everywhere. And another requirement, I am assuming that D is some kind of open set. So for time being, just you can assume that okay, there exists certain kind of open set, and their structure is like ball, and where this boundary is not included, containing the origin, and inside this boundary I have origin. So all state variable is lie inside the some part of Rn, but not everywhere. I am assuming that it only belongs to this particular region. And I have this kind of mapping. You can see that whenever I am writing x dot equal to fxt, xt belongs to d, but x dot maybe belongs to rn also, because I cannot control the rate of change. So rate of change maybe belongs to rn. And for time being, I am just assuming that this particular f function is continuous, and this is just in order to give that solution of this particular differential equation is exist. So that is just we are talking about the existence of solution. It is possible to show that all nonlinear differential equation, sum of nonlinear differential equation may not have solution, but if you put the continuity condition, then always there exists some kind of solution. So this is just for requirement. After that, now you can see that if I have some system like x dot equal to fxt, for simplicity I drop the notion of t, but here if you will put t, that doesn't matter. If you try to solve this, then I have x dot xt equal to x0, an integral of this particular quantity. Now what we are telling that, okay, I have certain kind of input, and input is basically coming from this set, and after that pictorial view I am going to show you that, okay, I have this system, I have given x0, and after that I am getting xt. So somehow this block is acts like some kind of function, because all physical system is acts like some kind of function. I have already told you that, and due to that reason we are denoting this whole things like this. So what we are telling that, okay, I have some kind of input or some kind of a state that lie inside this region, but x dot, and based on x dot, what happens? I have different region, and that is governed by some function f. So I have this kind of relation. Now let us come to the another part. After that, we are telling that xe is the equilibrium point of this system. So what is meaning of equilibrium point? If you put that equilibrium point in that differential equation, then rate of change is going to cease. And due to that region, xe, if you substitute, then x dot equal to 0. Now let us try to talk the stability. Now what we are telling that this system, whatever system I have taken, that is x dot equal to fx, and I have told you that I am not going to talk stability of whole system. I am going to talk about stability about the equilibrium point, stability about the some reference point, because nonlinear system, so nonlinear system is very, very complex. Some equilibrium point may be stable, some equilibrium point may not be. And due to that reason, I have to become very, very specific. So due to that reason, we are telling that the equilibrium is said to be stable if for every epsilon there exists a delta such that if x0 minus xe less than delta, then for every t greater than 0, we have xt minus xe less than epsilon. And you can see that this symbol represent the norm of some system. Now let us try to see the definition. What happens that whenever engineering people have developed some new system, so most of time they are two way. Either they consult to the consumer and they are asking their requirement, or somehow they are predicting the requirement of consumer. So first they are predicting the output, and based on that output they are talking about the input. So similar way you can see that whenever we are talking about Lyapunov stability, I am going to talk about some kind of term, and that term is, now you can see that I am going to talk about epsilon greater than 0, and try to see that how basically epsilon is connected. Epsilon is connected here. And what is meaning of this particular quantity? Xe is the my equilibrium point and Xt is the future trajectory. So what we are telling, okay, if I have some system like x dot equal to ft, and if I apply some kind of x0, then I will get xt. And you already know that in place of x0, if I apply xe, and xe is my equilibrium point. So try to see again. Suppose if I apply xe to same system as I'm writing, then what happens? Whatever xt that is going to generate, that equal to 0. Why that is 0? Because this is the equilibrium point. So if you start from equilibrium point, you are going to stay there. So what happens that by intuition of stability, what we have observed, that if my equilibrium point is in the vicinity of the if my perturbing point is in the vicinity of the equilibrium point, then we are assuming that future trajectory is also in the vicinity of the equilibrium point. That is the requirement. And I have told you that first, based on the consumer requirement, we are selecting the output, and due to that reason, first I fix the output ball. And what is output ball? It means that I have to talk about ball with respect to this particular quantity xt. So try to see from this particular figure. So what I have done, first I have taken some domain D, because my whole trajectory is going to remain inside D. After that, what I am going to see, that I have already assumed that whatever equilibrium point, that equilibrium point is going to lie inside that D. And due to that reason, I have fixed this point Xe. And I have to select output ball, because meaning of this norm, I have already explained, there is nothing but ball, some kind of ball in higher dimensional space. If you have two dimensional space, then some kind of circle or ellipse you can tell. So I have fixed this particular ball. And after that, we are telling that corresponding to this output ball, because after we are seeing the requirement of consumer, and based on their requirement, we are designing the some kind of input such that whatever requirement of consumer, that is satisfied. So we have to give guarantee that whatever input I have designed, whatever input designed by engineer, that will satisfy the requirement of the consumer, means output. It means that for every epsilon, means what we are telling, that if I have flexibility, and if consumer is telling I want to build some kind of machine that will work for this particular purpose, so even if they will scale out the machine, so scaling out means sometime it might possible that machine is work for some heavy purpose, sometime some small purpose, so I can scale it. Due to that reason, for every epsilon, means so when system is stable about some equilibrium point, so you can choose any output ball, size of output ball. We are telling that there exists a delta greater than zero, means input ball. So you can see here, after fixing the output ball, now I have no flexibility on the input ball, input ball. And why I am telling delta as a input ball? Because here you can see that x zero initial condition I am giving, and that is with respect to x equilibrium point. And due to that reason, we are telling this as a input ball, x zero minus x e less than delta. So if you fix the output ball, then corresponding to output ball, there exists an input ball, and their radius is delta. So same kind of things I have basically shown in this figure. And now what we are telling, that if you maintain your initial condition here in this particular system, I have already told you that input is nothing but the initial condition, because I am talking about internal stability of the system. So there is no need to worry about any external input. Just input is due to some kind of internal condition, internal state, or whatever means loop we have designed for this particular system. So now, based on the requirement of the stability or intuition of stability or qualitative behavior of stability, if you start from here, you can see that it might possible you can go to the bigger ball, but again you are not going to leave this bigger ball. And due to that reason, this figure means if you will leave this ball again, even if you will return back, then also system is unstable. Why system is unstable? Because somehow my system already become damaged. So now I cannot able to understand that what is behavior of this system in this particular region. Due to that reason, I am telling my system is unstable. So I hope that you are able to understand the idea. So idea is very, very simple. Whenever I have system, then we are seeing the output requirement, and based on that output requirement, we are creating some kind of ball, output ball with respect to equilibrium point, and after that we are selecting input ball. Input ball is nothing but internal state with respect to Xe, and after that we are giving guarantee that if you start from input ball and if you remains inside the output ball, then system is stable. If system is unstable, then it is possible to show that this kind of things never happens. So now definition of instability or unstability is very, very simple, that corresponding to output ball, you are unable to select input ball. And how to actually calculate epsilon, and means how to actually talk about stability using this definition, first you have to solve differential equation, because I know the equilibrium point and xt. If I do not know xt, I cannot do anything. So two step, you have to solve the differential equation, and after that you have to see the epsilon delta formulation, and I will tell you in next class how to formulate epsilon delta. And somehow what we are telling, that if bounded means output remains inside ball, means somehow we are talking about boundedness. So somehow stability also give the idea of boundedness, and due to that reason I have retained this. Now if you remember our discussion sometime before, I have taken one example of the satellite, and that is geostationary satellite. So in case of stability, what we have observed, if I start from the input ball, then I am going to remains inside the output ball. And how basically we are selecting ball? First we are fixing the output ball, then corresponding to output ball we are talking about input ball. So please be careful. So I have no flexibility on input ball after fixing the output ball. Another important thing what we have observed, that whenever we are talking about stability, at that time we are not giving guarantee that system after going to the output ball, they come back to the equilibrium point. But suppose you launch some kind of geostationary satellite, so stability means there are, it might possible if that will putter by plus minus delta, then behavior remains the same, but that is not the case always. Due to that reason, I have to give guarantee that even some perturbation comes into picture in the initial condition. Initial condition means operating condition we have maintained, such that will maintain that particular orbit. Now after fluctuation, I have to again give guarantee that come back to the same trajectory, means I have to make error, because I have already told you that whenever we are talking about operating point, then we have to talk everything in terms of error, then everything remains the same. Due to that reason, I am talking in terms of error if we have to track some operating point, or if we have equilibrium point, it means that finally we have to come back to the equilibrium point. So due to that reason, second notion of stability is coined by again the same scientist Lyapunov, and that is called asymptotic stability. So try to see the definition. If you understood the previous definition, then it is very easy to understand this definition also. So the equilibrium point of the autonomous system x dot equal to fx is said to be asymptotically stable if it is. So first important requirement is that should be Lyapunov stable. So Lyapunov stable means for every output ball I can select the input ball, because if you leave that output ball, then somehow requirement, we do not care the requirement of user. So we have done some kind of unnecessary thing. it might possible for nonlinear system in that particular, beyond that particular region, our model is not valid. I do not know what kind of things is going to happen. Due to that reason, I have to make sure about this. First point. And after that, here you can see that I am talking about AND operator. And there exists delta greater than 0 such that if you can see that for stability, I am telling that x0 minus x is less than delta, then I have to also talk about this limit t tending towards infinity, xt minus x0 tending towards 0, and so this we are talking, or somehow we are talking like this. Parallelly, this implies that xt is actually tending towards the xe. So this is the vector and this is the vector. So each component of this vector should converge to this vector. And due to that reason, now come to the figure. So here you can see that first I again fix the output ball, and corresponding to that I have designed the input ball. So due to that reason, I have written delta, that is function of epsilon. So this is epsilon, and after that we are telling that meaning of stability. What is meaning of stability? That if I start from here, then okay, I will leave somewhere in the bigger ball also. But now, so this is stable, but not asymptotically stable. Meaning of asymptotic stability is that I have to converge to the equilibrium point. So if I start, obviously you have to not start from here, because if you start from here, so by definition of equilibrium point, you are going to stay here. But if you have this kind of behavior, you can see that first I have left this region and again I will come back. Then also this system is not asymptotically stable. Why? Because I do not know what is the model beyond this particular region, beyond this output ball. And due to that region, even if I have behavior like this, means I will converge to equilibrium point, and this system is not asymptotically stable or not stable. So whenever we are talking about the asymptotic stability, you can see that I am talking about two things. So first thing is somehow I am talking about boundedness, because that is meaning of stability, plus here I am talking about attractivity. So attractivity to the equilibrium point or operating point. Equilibrium point. So meaning of asymptotic stability is boundedness of the trajectory about the equilibrium points, plus I have attractive behavior, means finally I will converge to the equilibrium point. So this is a stronger condition than stability, and most of engineering system should satisfy this kind of requirement. Because finally, suppose if I have installed one air conditioner inside some room, and due to sudden rise of temperature, suppose that if temperature is not 18 degree, that is fluctuated to 20 degree, then I cannot tell that, okay, if temperature is 19.5, then that is okay. We have to give guarantee that, okay, after some time again, temperature become 18 degree. Due to that reason, attractivity is one of the most important requirement of the engineering system. Now, let us come to the third kind of stability. That is called exponential stability. So far what we have observed, that means meaning of stability is some kind of boundedness. After that, meaning of asymptotic stability means boundedness plus attractivity. But whenever system converges towards the equilibrium point, we haven't talked about the rate. So suppose that if satellite will geostationary satellite is deviated from their orbit, and if I will tell that, okay, that will converge, but that will converge after 5 years, then that is useless for me. So I have to talk about the rate of convergence. So we have to make rate also. So now I have to talk about three different things. So first thing is boundedness plus attractivity plus rate of convergence, and due to that reason I have this kind of notion of exponential stability comes into picture. So let us try to see the definition. The equilibrium of x dot equal to fx is said to be exponentially stable if it is asymptotically stable. Asymptotically stable means stable plus after some time trajectory converges to the equilibrium point. And after that, I am talking about the rate also. And how basically we are talking about rate, there exists a alpha, beta and delta. So we are telling that there exists three different constant, all are positive. So if this is ball of initial condition, then always this kind of requirement I have. So you can see that this is output ball xt minus x0 xe, because here xt means output is involved. Here whatever initial condition I have provided, that is involved. So due to that reason, we are telling this as an input ball or ball of initial condition. And here alpha, and here you can see that exponential term is involved, e power minus beta t. So you can start from any initial condition. You can see that after with exponentially faster rate, I can forget about that equilibrium point. And due to that reason, name of this stability is called exponential stability. Now, I have told you that I have two different class of system. So in some class of system, I have more than one isolated equilibrium point. And whenever I have more than one isolated equilibrium point, then what happens and what is definition of equilibrium point? If you start from there, you are going to stay there. So if I have two equilibrium point, then I cannot tell that one equilibrium point is globally. Globally means same kind of behavior throughout. So at least there exists some kind of singularity point. If you start from there, you will not move. But try to see the example of linear system. What happens, or some class of nonlinear system also, same kind of behavior, we have a unique equilibrium point. And whenever we have unique equilibrium point, it might possible that if I start anywhere in the space, I will converge to that equilibrium point. And due to that reason, global or local stability concept comes into picture. So similarly, people are telling global asymptotic stability, global exponential stability. If you start anywhere, you are going to converge to the equilibrium point. But most of time, if you have unique equilibrium point, then only you can talk about this. So next definition, I'm going to talk about the global, or similarly, people are talking about local. Local means we are not worrying about the whole space, because most of time practical system, whenever we are talking about practical system, we have limitation. So we are assuming that okay, a state will not go to very very large. If that will remains inside some region, well defined region, then also my requirement is satisfied. So there is no need to worry about the global stability. Local stability enough to design lot of engineering system. So let us try to see the statement of this definition. If asymptotic or exponential stability holds for any initial state, so now you have flexibility, you can select any initial state. So similarly, if you are scaling your input ball, output ball is also on the whole space, the equilibrium point is said to be asymptotically or exponentially stable in large, and it is called globally or exponentially stable. Now, let us come to the second class of system, that is non-autonomous system. Again, I am assuming I have no forcing function. If I have forcing function, then I will select that forcing function in terms of the state or time, function of state and time. So I have to convert force system into non-autonomous system. So again, same kind of physical interpretation. Now I have two different input, x0, and here t0 is also input, because this is explicitly depending on the initial time also. And after that, you can see that I have xt. And again, similar kind of definition I have made, that since this is nonlinear system, so again, that is going to means model is only valid in some well-defined region. So I have selected some well-defined region as a D, that is subset of Rn, or proper subset of Rn, that is also okay. And I am assuming that that contain the equilibrium point. This is very, very important because this is my reference point, and about that only we are talking about stability. And you all are all already well aware that how to define the equilibrium point for non-autonomous system. So for all t, this condition should be satisfied. Now let us try to come to the definition, and definition of stability is here, is like this. The equilibrium point xe of this system is stable. So again, definition is remains the same like the autonomous case, but I have told you that now input is not only function of x0, but that is function of the t0 also, and due to that reason, if you select the output ball, and here I have defined my output ball by epsilon, then there exists a delta, and now delta ball is function of output ball as well as this variable explicit time t0. So if you start your experiment in morning, then time is different. If you start in evening or afternoon, time is different. And after that, again, same kind of requirement we are telling. So that is just extension of idea of autonomous things to non-autonomous, and everything remains the same. So we are telling corresponding to output ball, there exists some kind of input ball, and that is also function of t0. And if you start from input ball, and if you are going to remain inside the output ball with respect to the equilibrium point, then system is called stable. Please be careful whenever you are talking about input ball and output ball. So please define what is meaning of input ball and output ball. Otherwise, people will confuse with input and output. So meaning of input ball is the ball about the equilibrium point corresponding to the initial condition. Or in case of non-autonomous system, that is function of t0 also. Now another more stability that comes into picture, that is called uniform stability. And I have told you that if you develop some system that is explicit function of time, then somehow that is very difficult for the engineering operation, because always you have to take care about the time. Due to that reason, it is possible to show that even if system is non-autonomous, people try to develop those class of system where this ball, means ball of initial condition about the equilibrium point, that is independent of the selection of the time. And if we are able to do so for some system, then that system is called uniformly stable. Uniformly means for all t greater than or equal to t0, same kind of behavior I have. So uniform stability, this is the definition of uniform stability. So somehow whenever we are on the autonomous case, we are talking about this kind of stability requirement. So if we are talking about uniform stability, then both autonomous and non-autonomous case is the same. Similarly, I can extend this for asymptotic stability, and idea is again remains the same. What is idea? We are telling that not only stable, we have to converge to the equilibrium point. So we are telling that system is asymptotic stable if it is stable and there is a positive constant C T0 such that this requirement will satisfy, means xt tending towards 0 as t tending towards infinity for all this kind of condition. Here that is xt tending towards equilibrium point, so here equilibrium point is xe, so this is not 0, that is xe as t tending towards infinity. And what is meaning of exponential stability? Same like the case of autonomous system, that should satisfy this kind of condition for all if you select the initial condition ball in this particular region. So now I am going to conclude this lecture. So what we have seen in this lecture, we have seen the intuition of stability. Still, what is remaining? That remaining is that first, you can see that in order to talk about the stability in the sense of Lyapunov, I have to solve the differential equation. So in next class, I will take some kind of numerical example, some kind of practical example, where first we will solve the differential equation, and after that I will tell you that how to formulate the epsilon and delta ball, and after that try to match with what kind of stability, either system is stable, asymptotically stable, or exponentially stable. Again, globally asymptotically stable or locally asymptotically stable. So with this remark, I am going to conclude the today's lecture. So thank you very much.